Basement of the house, half a block down the street from Jerry's bait shop. You know the place. Well, anyway, back then life was going swell and everything was just peachy. Except, of course, for the undeniable fact that every single morning, my mother would make me a big old bowl of sauerkraut for breakfast. I said, "Hey, Mom, what's up with all the sauerkraut?" And my dear sweet mother, she leaned right down next to me. For you! And then she tied me to the wall and stuck a funnel in my mouth and force-fed me nothing but sour cream until I was 26 and a half years old. That's when I swore that someday I would get out of that basement and travel to a magical, faraway place where the sun is always shining and the air smells like warm root beer and the towels are oh so fluffy, where the Shriners and the Lepers play their ukuleles all day long and anyone on the street will gladly shave your back for a nickel. Next day, a local radio station had this contest to see who could correctly guess the number of molecules in Leonard Nimoy's butt. I was off by three, but I still won the grand prize. That's right, a first-class one-way ticket. Albuquerque. Finally, I arrived at the world-famous Albuquerque Holiday Inn, where the towels are oh so fluffy, and you can eat your soup right out of the ashtrays if you want. I checked into my room, and I turned down AC and I turn on the spectrovision and I'm just about to eat that little chocolate mint on my pillow that I love so very, very much when suddenly there's a knock on the door. Well, now who could that be? I say, who is it? No answer. Who is it? There's no answer. Who is it? And I'm saying anything. So finally I go over and I open the door and just as I suspected, it's some big fat hermaphrodite with a flock of seagulls haircut and only one nostril. So anyway, he burst into my room and he grabbed my lucky snorkel and I'm like, hey, you can't have that! That snorkel's been just like a snorkel to me! Well, to cut a long story short, he got away with my snorkel. But I made a solemn vow right then and there that I would not rest. I would not sleep for an instant until the one nostril man was brought to justice. But first I decided to buy some donuts. So I got in my car and I drove over to the donut shop and yeah, what do you want? I said, you got any glazed donuts? He said, nah, we're out of glazed donuts. I said, well, you got any jelly donuts? He said, nah, we're out of jelly donuts. I said, you got any bear claws? He said, wait a minute, I'll go check. Nah, we're out of bear claws! Anyway, anyway, I know it's kind of a roundabout way of saying it, but I guess the whole point I'm trying to make here is I hate sauerkraut! That's all I'm really trying to say. And by the way, if one day you happen to wake up and find yourself in an existential quandary, full of loathing and self-doubt and racked with the pain and isolation of your pitiful, meaningless existence, at least you can take a small bit of comfort in knowing that somewhere out there in this crazy old mixed-up universe of ours, there's still a little place